You, dance with me now.
Yes, you. Hurry. The waltz is about to start.
Please don't pretend you don't know who I am.
Of course I'm not trying to court you. Did you really think someone like you was worthy of a prince's attention?
Who is your father?
An earl?
A viscount?
A merchant? So you're a commoner?
Yes, you are.
You have no titles and no lands. You're a very wealthy and influential commoner, but a peasant nonetheless.
I did not ask you to dance because I wished to court you. I did it for my own advantage.
The king and queen have been relentless in their drive to see me married. Ever since the social season began, they've thrown one of these posh gigs every week and demanded that I attend. Frankly, it's exhausting. Especially seeing as I have no desire to be married.
Of course not. Who would want to be?
Forever tied to a person whom you have no affection for? Forced to keep an amicable relationship for the sake of appearance? And, for someone of my station, forced to consummate your marriage while your parents and all the nobles watch? All these lords and ladies in attendance, all clamoring for a spouse. They don't even know what they're asking for.
I see. So you feel the same way.
Perhaps there is something in that peasant head of yours after all.
You know, you are unusually beautiful for a peasant. You clearly outshine all the other guests in attendance.
No, do not mistake my praise for interest. Your beauty is the reason I approached you, but not for the reason you might be imagining.
I've seen the way the suitors have been swarming you all night.
Excuse me, you look ravishing. May I have this dance?
Be honest. How many times have you heard those words tonight?
An extraordinary amount. I thought so.
You must be tired of them. I'm sorry, one moment.
Excuse me, can we please play something with a little step? What, are we trying to put people to sleep on the dance floor? As you were.
My apologies. As I was saying, as we are clearly on the same page in regards to marriage, it may be to our mutual benefit to keep up this farce.
What do I mean? As long as we're seen together, enjoying each other's company as we are, there's no reason for any suitors to hound either one of us.
Think, who would try to compete for your affections when you have a prince on your arm? And what person in their right mind would think they could take anyone's attention off someone as beautiful as you? They wouldn't even bother trying. We would be left alone, free to do as we please, at least until the social season ends. Then we go our separate ways.
So, my beautiful peasant, are you up for this little charade?
What do you mean?
You don't like being called peasant? All right, fine then. Commoner, I...
Hey, where are you going? Don't walk away from me. Where are you going? Excuse me. It is rude to just walk away from someone in the middle of a ball.
You surely have the manners of a cop.
Did you just punch a prince?
My nose is bleeding.
What in God's name did you do that for?
For calling you a peasant?
Then what should I call you? Insane?
No. I can clean up my own blood. I don't need your help.
Fine. You may help me. I suppose you did cause this mess.
What?
What did you just call me? Entitled. Bratty. Do you realize who you're speaking to? I am the prince. What gives you the right to call me? Fine. Your point is taken. I apologize. I am sorry for calling you a peasant. Although I don't think it warranted you punching me. Allow me to correct my mistake. I'm pleased to make your acquaintance. I'm Prince Desmond, first in line to the throne. You'll have to forgive my appearance. I was just set upon by brigands who broke my nose. Did you just strike me again? I have never met someone so bold in my entire life. What is your name? That is a beautiful name. Even if it does belong to such a beastly individual. Nobody has ever spoken to me the way that you have. As much as I hate to admit it, I feel there is some truth to what you said. I suppose that's the reason I didn't call the guards after you struck me. Oftentimes I hear the servants in the palace gossiping about me. They don't think I hear them, but I do. Ever since I was a child, they've called me all sorts of cruel names. Entitled, spoiled rotten, sheltered. Sure, they're nice to my face, but only because they have to be. The truth is, I've never left the palace grounds before. Everyone calls me privileged for growing up with such luxury, but it doesn't feel that way. This castle is a prison. That's why I refuse to ever be married. Doing so would mean resigning myself to this life forever. A curated and carefully planned life where I can't make any decisions of my own. So I humbly ask you again. Will you continue our false courtship until the suitors have all gone? You will. That's great. Thank you. Well then, shall we return to the ball? Another! It's okay. This robe obscures my face well enough. Nobody here is going to recognize me. Nobody that doesn't already know who I am. We're here often enough. Come on, stop being so serious. We're celebrating. The social season is over. All of those tired old men and desperate ladies are going back where they came from. And most importantly, you and I have escaped the season without a single marriage proposal. Cheers to us. The thoughts that must have been going through people's heads. A prince and a merchant's heir sneaking off into town every night. The scandal. But you know what? I don't care. Let them gossip. Let them think what they want about their spoiled prince. Because this summer, spent with the beautiful heir of a merchant, was the best of my life. I wouldn't trade this for anything. Yes, that is really how I feel. So, what shall we do tomorrow? My fencing instructor will be trialing my skills tomorrow, so it might take me a bit longer than usual to sneak out the palace, but What do you mean you can't meet up tomorrow? Do you have some sort of prior commitment? Oh. Of course. Everyone else is leaving for the end of the season. I forgot that must include you as well. Well, I'd like to thank you for showing me around the city all these nights. I may not ever be entirely free, but escaping the palace this summer truly felt like it. Where will you go? Across the ocean to visit new trade partners. That sounds like an adventure. Well then, thank you. I know the nature of our relationship was to be purely transactional, but I do feel as if I've become a better person by knowing you. So, thank you. Well, if that's all, then this is goodbye. I'll take my leave. No, there's nothing wrong with me. Everything is fine. Everything went as it should. Our relationship was a ruse. We both got what we wanted, and now it's over. It's been a pleasure, Merchant. Wait. Marry me. Yes. I said marry me. The season is over, true. But there will be others. We fended off the suitors for now, but what about next year? And the year after that? A more permanent solution would be our union. We could continue as we have this summer, having fun, as friends. With a spouse, I would finally be free to leave the castle. I could come with you on your journey. Yes, royal responsibilities may eventually catch up to us. But my parents are young and healthy. Problems of that nature are a long ways off. So I'll ask again. Will you marry me?